Canva launched a bunch of new features, and in today's Canva tutorial, I want to share with you a few of them. This is like little bite-sized brownie of Canva. Some of these features I've been asking for a couple of years now. Let's look at the brand new animations. Click on your picture, click on the word animate. Slide over here, we have shake zoom, whip slide, old TV, chroma wave. So let's click on shake zoom. The Canva Pro features, you can slow it down or speed it up. And you can also change the intensity for whip slide. You can change the speed and the direction. For old TV, you can change the speed. Of course, you can also, with all of these, change the animation, whether you want it on both, on enter, or just on exit. I think old TV actually would look nice on exit. And then we've got chroma wave, where you can speed it up or slow it down. I know that was really short, but I will have an extended video on animations in general, talking about text, element, photo, even video animations, timing of animations and things like that. So ask me for the updated animation tutorial if that's something that you need. Canva also released a new way to edit photos. Let's look and see real quickly what background generator can do. So let's click our image, click on edit, and then we're gonna head over to BG generator. What this is going to do is generate a whole new background for this image. Because my brain is farting right now, I'm just gonna click inspire me, and then we can click generate. After you have these options, we are going to click a button to allow the lighting to match up with the background. There's this one, and next we have this one, then there's this one, and finally this one. Click on that sunshine button. The two options you have are balanced relight and maximum relight. For this one, I like both, but I think I'm gonna stick with maximum and click done. This picture has a whole new background and the lighting is balanced so that it really matches. I really like that feature. I think it would pair, actually, this is gonna sound crazy, but I think it would pair really nicely with background remover, because then you've adjusted the way your subject looks. How could we as YouTubers use this? One way I'm thinking is for YouTube thumbnails. This next feature I have anticipated for a couple years. If you don't believe me, watch this.
They've got Canva Docs, have Canva Sheets. They don't have an Excel equivalent with engine, and I could see that being on their roadmap.
Canva created Canva Docs, you know, as a Word or Google Doc alternative. They should create a Canva Sheets as an Excel or Google Sheets alternative. I want it to be a full-on brand new document type. Do you see right under me, there is a little circle that says coming soon? I don't know this. And anything that actually comes, if I've mentioned any of it, it's just a complete fluke. Like, I don't have any knowledge of things that are actually coming, but that little button, sometimes Canva gives us little clues about what's gonna be happening, and that little button, all of the other things are icons. So you see how it's got YouTube thumbnail, doc, whiteboard, presentation, social media, video, print, website, and then there's custom, size, upload, and then more. These are all Canva document types that Canva has. And the thing that Canva doesn't have are sheets. They do now. In that little segment, I didn't do a deep dive about Canva Sheets, and that's simply because I've not had enough time to look and investigate to see exactly what you can do with it. So what I thought I would do is take a minute or two to open up Canva Sheets and sort of give my first impressions. Although I'm going to admit, my husband is a connoisseur of spreadsheets. I'm not. But I'm hoping that over a little bit of time, I'll be able to find ways that this spreadsheet is going to really work for us as content creators. Let's go and just take a peek around Canva Sheets right now. Create new. 2 minutes. I mean, it looks like a spreadsheet to me where you can move things. Yep, there. Let's see if do I have to type T or anything? I do not. What I want to know is number format. Oh, look. So there's number formats, more formats. Okay, let's just take a look real quick. I don't want to spend a lot of time here. Since it's like a spreadsheet, I'm like, let me get an equal sign and see what happens. There's some average count, min, max, all functions. So that's cool. They've got magic formula. Let's see what these actions are. So, you know, if I did this, 2 plus 2, 4, quick action, generate table, fill table, magic charts, which I know magic charts is new, magic insight. Okay, it looks like Magic Insight has 500 credits. Oh, I'm running very short on time. My timer's about to go away. Magic chart. Oh, that's that. Number formatting. Background color. Borders or whatnot. Let's see. I don't know. I don't know how this all works because it's brand new. And this is the second time I've gone into this. But what I do know is that supposedly you can bulk action things. Let's see. Let's just do one thing. Let's see if I click all of these and then click action. I don't know how you would do that. Canva design, maybe? No, that's not Canva design. Oh, so when I click one, I can click edit and do things. I thought that you could do it to multiple ones, but who knows? Anyway, it's just you can put pictures in here. So maybe we could do titles, thumbnails, things like that. That's all I'm going to look at it. I would love to know what your thoughts are on incorporating Canva Sheets in your workflow for your YouTube channel. If you've ever complained about being organized within Canva, this next feature is for you. Before we watch this little clip, I would like for you to think about this. With this feature I'm about to show you, you're going to be able to have one project for a video that you're creating. And you can have one page that is a document just for planning. You could have one page that is just thumbnail ideas and thumbnails for that project. You could have another page for a YouTube short that you've made. You could have another page for the video itself or for lower thirds or overlays, and you can have all of these different sized designs all in one project. I'm super excited about this and can't wait to explore it more. But in the meantime, watch this brownie-sized bite of what it can do. We can now have multiple sizes in the same document type. This design is 16 by 9, and if I scroll down, this one's 9 by 16. What you're going to do is click the down arrow. This brings up everything. Let's say I want to add a document to plan my videos. It pulls up a document for me. I couldn't figure out how to get to my design, so I did go back and go into it to see, and it pulled up this view. And so I was able to see the document actually was within the design. Now we can see the presentations, the mobile video, and now the document all in the same design. So we're going to add a new page type. Let's do social media. Let's do a 4x5. If I look at grid view, you can see here at the bottom, social media page, video page, doc page, social media page. All of them are different. I am super excited to be able to explore all the options that we have with this new way of designing. I'm curious, what kind of document types are you thinking about putting together in one project? Canva fixed a problem that many of us have been complaining about for years. The scripty fonts weren't scripty. You could move the spacing closer together, but it just did not look good. And with this latest feature, Canva fixed it. Let me show you what it can do. Do you see how this word Canva is not connected, but this word Canva is? That's thanks to a brand new feature called Ligatures. And this works best with a scripty font. So for this example, I'm using Playwright US Trad. You're going to click over Advanced Formatting. You'll have General. This is generally what things will be, which has no text position at all. And then you have Superscript and Subscript. But we're going to leave this one at the regular A2 position. Slide over to Typography. You're going to notice that there is a new feature called Kerning, which you can turn on. But this is the one that I'm loving. It's called Ligatures. It combines specific characters elegantly. When we flip this over, Canva is now scripty. I have to tell you, when I saw that feature, I was so excited. Like, I rarely use scripty fonts in Canva because of the issue of the letters not connecting to each other. And now they can. And this feature is an update. It's an update to color edit. I absolutely love this feature. So let's take a look and see what it can do. Before, what you would need to do if you wanted to change a color was click edit, go to adjust, and scroll down until you found the color edit option. However, you don't need to do that anymore. Click the image and go up here and click the color you would like to change. And now the color panel opens up and you can change it to anything that you like. Let's change it to this dark turquoise. And now we've got a brand new color on a photo without having to open up the adjust panel. There are so many more features left to explore, like Canva AI, which let me just show you real quickly what it looks like. If we click Canva AI, design for me, create an image, draft a doc, and even code for me. That's right, Canva can now code. See what you can do with AI, and then it shows you different things that you can do using AI inside of Canva. Another new thing that I've not explored yet, not really, is this photo editor where you can bring it up, and there's things like auto select. Here's the background generator that we talked about earlier today. Here's something new, perspective correction. What I want you to do is tell me what feature you would really love for me to do a deep dive on that's going to help you with your YouTube channel. I don't know what video I'm going to put up on the screen, but I promise you it's worth the watch if you use Canva and if you have a YouTube channel.